Okay, so hopefully that's me warmed up now after the first video for the day. Okay, so I think a lot of people see these and get a bit upset because there's quite a lot of information coming at you in graphs and words. So let's just read through the question to begin with, okay? So we've got a parabola. And the first thing I notice with a parabola is the shape of it. Okay, so it's not the classic shape. It's not the, just draw it here. It's not a positive parabola, you know, it's inverted. Okay, so right away I'm thinking we're going to have some kind of, you know, negative x squared when I see this, okay? That's the first thing I think about. I also see this coordinate as well, one coordinate. And we know that's the maximum turning point, and it just restates the turn by the value there. So there's nothing really new in this bit. I don't really need any of that, okay? Because we know that that's the turning point. We can see it, okay? So it's just asking for the equation of symmetry to begin with. Quite straightforward. So what point is a symmetrical? So if we were to draw a line, oh, let's just, let's see. Here, okay, a straight line. Try that again, sorry. My apologies. That's also terrible. Oh no. What a terrible, terrible start to this video as well. Uh-oh. I'm trying to some new settings on the pad that seems to be not working terribly well in my favour. See, I'm just going to move that with the mouse. If I was doing this by hand, I would have finished the question by now. Let's just imagine that's a vertical line. So that's our axis of symmetry. So the axis of symmetry is parallel to the y-axis. It's on the x-axis. That line, we would just say that is x equals 4. Okay? Nice and straightforward. X equals 4. Okay? It's just a vertical line. X is always equal to 4 on this line. Okay? Likewise, a horizontal line would be a y equals. Okay? So that's the equation of the axis of symmetry. Everyone always forgets. Everyone seems to just write down 4, you know, so just remember x is equal to 4, and that's your one mark, nice and straightforward. And the next question for A and B, and then again, looking at the marks, two marks here, and you're only really told 4 and 20, okay? So have a guess. If you're not really sure, just have a stab with the numbers 4 and 20, okay? Now, the easiest thing, or I think this makes it a bit easier, I would rewrite this equation and say, well, this is the same as minus x plus a squared plus b. Okay, that's the exact same thing. Okay, and there's our minus x because we know it's a negative parabola. And we've got this plus b on the end. And that is the easiest number, I think, to work out on these graphs because all that does is move the graph vertically up or down. Okay, so your standard y equals x squared would be something like this. And your standard y equals minus x squared would be something like this. Okay. So we've got this graph and we've moved it up the way and we've moved it along the way. And to move it up and down the way is this number here. So it should be sat here on the zero line. But we've moved it up. So now it's turning at 20 rather than turning at zero. So B is going to be the 20. Okay. So that's the easiest number, I think, to work out. And then you've got your A number in here. Okay. So we know we've moved it to the right. Again, it should be on the zero. Okay, the graph should touch this point right here. I'm just highlighting that. It should touch right in there at 0, 0. I don't know what's going on with my pen today. But it's not. It's at 420. So we moved it to the right by 4. So guessing plus or minus 4 is fair. Okay. The answer, because you're moving it to the right, is minus 4. Okay, and the reason that is, if you imagine, say if we've not got a B, okay, I'll draw it right in, just minus 4, okay. The reason that is, if you imagine the turning point, okay, so that's the biggest number that this equation can give you. The biggest number this equation can give you is going to be here, it's going to be 20, okay, or whatever number. Now, this B here, we know that's 20, so it means that this part of the equation is going to have to become 0. In order for this equation to work, okay? So if we've got x plus a squared, or minus x plus a squared, that has to equal 0. So how do we get this equation to equal 0? Well, when x is 4, we have to do 4 minus 4 to get our 0. Yeah, 4 minus 4 would give us 0. Okay, so that's why if you kind of think of your equation, you can kind of work back and say, well, that makes sense actually, because when x is 4, if I do 4 minus 4, that's 0, and then this equation works. Okay, so that's one way you could maybe think about it. Okay, but if you just learn the rules as well, if you're moving the graph to the right, it's going to be a negative, even though this is the negative coordinate on the left. But that's why, because you're trying to get this part of the bracket to be 0. Okay, so have a guess. Worst case scenario, just have a guess. Okay, when you see the ones, you know it's going to be a straightforward question. All right. Okay, vectors. Again, nice and straightforward with vectors. So we know we've got a triangle PQR, we've got our PR vector, we've got an RQ vector. Okay, so PQ in component form. So then with vectors, is you add them head to toe. Now they've told us PR and they've told us RQ. Okay, so we can just go ahead and add them. Okay, and again, it's one mark. You know, it's going to be a nice straightforward question. Okay, so we've got 6. Right. There, 6 and minus 4, and we've got minus 1, minus 1, 8. So if we just add these vectors together, we are going to get the new vector P to Q, where we're going to get this vector here. Okay, so 6 minus 1 gives us 5. Minus 4 plus 8 is going to give us 4. Nice and straightforward. Okay. So the only thing that's hard with that, or that could potentially be hard, would be to know that you have to add vectors head to toe. Okay. Which we've already got. So that's brilliant. N is the midpoint. Express M to Q in component form. So now we're going from M to R and R to Q. So again, head to toe. Now, if that's in the midpoint of PR, then M to R is just going to be a half of PR. Okay? So what we can do is do the exact same thing, except we'll put a little half in front. So we'll say, well, a half, just put our work in for this as well, a half PR. I'm not quite sure why I think you're doing this. A half PR plus RQ is going to equal MQ. So a half PR, I'll just kind of do this in my head, so it's going to be 3 and minus 2, yeah, which is half both the numbers. And then RQ is just the same, so it's just minus 1 and 8. And then we're just going to add them together. 3 minus 1 is 2, minus 2 plus 8 is 6. Okay, and for your marks for that one, you would get a mark for this first step where you show your working. And again, it's good to show that because you might make a little mistake here. And if you make a mistake here, you get nothing. So, you know, do show what your thinking is, because you could have gone the other way. You could have said, I'm going to go M to P and then P to Q, because we know what P to Q is. Yeah, but what you would have had to have done was done negative PM. Because we know what P to M is, so for M to P we'd have to do negative, wouldn't we? So it would have been the negative of this number plus that number. Should have given us the same thing. Okay. So yeah, it's good just showing that you understand the head-to-tail concept and then working through the simple addition and just one up for this. Okay, so nice and straightforward, but yeah, don't forget to show your working. That's quite a big one. I'll just do this one separate.